Hello students, I hope you had already completed your yesterday's video, the sums which we had done, page number 56. Last class I had explained about the table, that is loan amount. I hope all had completed. So today we will continue our same exercise. Next part is gain and loss. Before doing the sums, I want to explain about what is gain, what is loss. If we will purchase some particular thing for a particular amount, and if we will sell to someone else, extra money we will get, then it is called a gain or profit. If less money we will get it, then we will call it as loss. So one simple example before we will do, I will say, suppose you purchase one pen for 10 rupees and you sold it to your friend for 12 rupees, you will get 2 rupees extra. So in this business, you got extra 2 rupees. So we can say it is a gain. So 10 rupees is the cost price and 12 rupees is the selling price. If selling price is more than cost price, then we can say it is a gain, or another word is profit. Suppose you purchased one pencil for 6 rupees and you sold it to your friend for 4 rupees. So here the business is a loss. Suppose you had spent 6 rupees but you got back only 4 rupees. So in this business, cost price is more than selling price, so we will say it is a loss. So related to this only, this particular exercise. So you can see now, first question. Sasmita bought a cycle for 2200 rupees and sold to Mohan for rupees 2800. So here cost price is 2200 and selling price is 2800. Find the amount of her gain or loss. So naturally you can see selling price is more than cost price. So it is a gain. So how to write the step? You see here I had written cost price of a cycle is 2200. Selling price of the cycle is 2800. So the formula is, SP stands for selling price, CP stands for cost price. So SP minus CP, if selling price is more than cost price, then it is a gain. So here selling price is 2800 and cost price is 2200. So it is a gain or a profit. How many rupees? 2800 minus 2200, answer is 600. So please note down in your workbook today itself. First listen, then you copy it. Minerva bought 5 pens for rupees 20 each. So here 5 pens cost you have to find out, because 1 pen costing 20 rupees. Like that she purchased 5 pen. So we will find out cost price of 5 pen. Then sold all the pens to her friends for a total of rupees 90. So she sold all the 5 pen together to her friends for 90 rupees. Tell whether Minerva is in loss or not. If yes, how? So first we will see that cost price of a pen, each meaning is 1. So cost price of 1 pen or a pen equal to 20 rupees. Like that, how many pens she purchased? 5. So cost price of 5 pens equal to 1 given to find out more, always multiplication. So 20 multiplied by 5 equal to first 0 right and 5 twos are 10. So amount is 100 rupees. So cost price of 5 pen equal to 100 rupees. Same pen she sold to her friends for 90 rupees. So here selling price of 5 pen equal to how many? 90 rupees. So of course it is a loss, because she spent 100 rupees. She got back only 90 rupees. So it is loss. And Here CP is greater than SP. CP stands for cost price, SP stands for selling price. So CP minus SP equal to 100 minus 90 equal to rupees 10. So she got loss 10 rupees. Now third number C. Nitika bought three pairs of gloves for rupees 180. So here this girl purchased three pairs of gloves, which is using in our hands. So it will be always in pairs because we are having two hands, right hand and left hand. So one pair consists of two numbers. So she purchased three pairs, so six gloves. Three pairs of gloves for 180 rupees and sold each pair, one pair she sold for 90 rupees. So find the amount of gain or loss in this deal. For this, we have to find out the selling price of three pairs. One pair given, so we have to find out three pairs. So see the step. CP of three pairs of gloves. CP means cost price of three pairs of gloves equal to rupees 180. SP of one pair. While selling, she didn't sell together. She sold one pair. So SP of one pair is given rupees 90. So how many pairs were there? Three pairs. So SP of three pairs we have to find out. For that, multiply. 90 multiplied by 3 equal to 3 zeros are 0, 3 nines are 27. So answer is 270. What was the cost price? 180 rupees. And what is the selling price? 270. So of course 270 is greater than 180. So here it is a profit. So SP minus CP equal to gain or profit. So profit equal to SP 270 minus 180 equal to rupees 90. I hope you had followed that. So note down in your workbook this sum and then turn the next page. We will continue. Here some word problems are there. One by one we will do it. Students, all the sums which we are doing in the workbook, you have to note down in your workbook. It is very important. Now, word problems. First question. Sohan bought four pencils for rupees 5. Mohan bought three notebooks for rupees 20 each. And Seema bought two erasers for rupees 2 each. How much did they pay to all together? So here you see first pencils cost price we have to find out. But only one pencil's rate is given rupees 5. How many pencils Sohan purchased? Four pencils. So CP of one pencil equal to 5 rupees. So CP of four pencils equal to 5 multiplied by 4, 20 rupees. Now Mohan bought three notebooks for rupees 20 each. Each means one. So cost price of one notebook equal to 20 rupees. Therefore cost price of three notebooks equal to 20 multiplied by 3 or 3 multiplied by 20 equal to rupees 60. Now third number, that is Seema bought two razors for rupees 2 each. She purchased two razors 2 rupees each. So the cost price of one razor is 2 rupees. So two razors equal to 2 multiplied by 2, 4 rupees. Now our question is how much did they paid all together? All the three together how much paid? So what we will do? All the three amount we will plus. First one 20 rupees plus second one 60 rupees plus third one 4 rupees. So 20 plus 60 plus 4. 20 plus 60 equal to 80. 80 plus 4, 84. So all the three students together how much paid? 84 rupees. Now question number B. Nikita bought 1 kg paneer for rupees 200 and sold it for 260 rupees per kg. Here, I hope everybody knowing what is paneer. It is a product of milk which is using for preparing the curries or the dishes. So 1 kg paneer she purchased for 200 rupees and she sold that same paneer for 260 rupees. So here selling price is more than cost price. Cost price is only 200, but selling price is 260. So 60 rupees she got extra. Now what is the question? Thus, the money she earned for 3 kg paneer, 1 kg paneer 200 rupees. So 3 kg paneer 260 rupees she got from selling 1 kg paneer. So if she sold 3 kg paneer, what will be her earning? That is the question. So look at the step. CP of 1 kg paneer equal to 200 rupees. Then SP of 1 kg paneer equal to 260 rupees. Therefore, the profit of 1 kg equal to 260 minus 200 equal to 60. So 1 kg paneer she got 60 rupees. If she will sell 3 kg, how many rupees she will get profit or gain? 3 multiplied by 60. So what will be the answer? 3 zeros are 0, 3 6 are 80. So she got the profit of 180 rupees for this selling of 3 kg paneer. I hope students you are following the chapter. If any doubt is there, you listen the video again, so you will clear your doubts. Now third number C. Sohail brought one rickshaw and there is a deal between the rickshaw puller and Sohail that every day he has to give rupees 30 to Sohail. Given below are the 5 days earning of rickshaw puller. What is the content of this question? One man, that is Sohail, purchased one rickshaw and he is not driving. He kept one person as a driver to pull the rickshaw or to drive the rickshaw. So it is called a rickshaw puller. So on rental basis, he had given the rickshaw. So what was the agreement given? Every day, that man who is riding that rickshaw, he should give rupees 30 to this owner. So here the number given below are the 5 days earning of the rickshaw puller. So rickshaw fellow, he is driving every day. So 5 days earning. First day 200 rupees he got. Second day 300 rupees. Third day 250 rupees. Fourth day 350 rupees. And fifth day 275 rupees. So now what is the question? You can see. Calculate the total amount of money the rickshaw puller will earn in 5 days. So our question is, after giving these 5 days 30 rupees each to this owner, what will be his income or how much he earned from these 5 days rickshaw pulling? So you can see the method. 5 days total earning will be, you can plus all these numbers I have written here, 200 plus 300 plus 250 plus 350 plus 275. Here there is no place for addition. So students, you take one rough paper and take these numbers outside and you can do addition and check this same answer is coming or not. So when we will plus all these numbers, you will get rupees 1375. Now there is one agreement is given. This is the total amount he got, but this full amount he cannot take because according to the agreement, every day 30 rupees he has to give to the owner. So how many days he had taken this riksha? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 days. So 5 days, 3 multiplied by 30. Sorry, 5 multiplied by 30. 5 days are taken riksha and 1 day 30 rupees giving. So what will be the amount to pay for this owner? 30 multiplied by 5 equal to 150. So what was the total money he got that 5 days he is running the rickshaw? 1375. So 1375 minus 150, we will get 1225. So this is the earning of that man after giving the rent to that Sohail. So 1375 minus 150. So the answer is 1225. Students, there is no place for doing addition and subtraction. So directly I had written answer, but you have to calculate in a rough paper and check your answer is right or not. I hope you had followed the chapter what I had explained today. And remaining we will continue in the next video. Till then you complete your work. If any day your work is incomplete, please try to see the video and complete your work. We will meet again in the next video. Till then, goodbye.